Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This one is an IMPO power supply type ES1117. IMPO is a company that makes all sorts of lab equipments for schools and stuff like that. So it is normally not that super sexy designed and all that. It's not for the looks. But there's plenty of space around buttons, and it's made super rugged. You can almost feel that, you know, it's super heavy and super, you know, capable of handling misuse and kits and whatnot. And see, somebody wrote their names here. I don't know. Why do kids do stuff like that? Making little drawings. Look at that. Absolutely stupid. But I think I can take an eraser and clean this up. At least I'm going to try a little bit. I heard there was something wrong with some of the pots or the voltage and stuff here, so as far as I can see, we can do both DC voltage and AC at the same time. Can you hear this? So it's either a big resistor or a variable transformer, and then you can just switch the meter, only 1 meter between voltage and current and all that. Oh, well, like plenty of space here to put more meters, but that is a little bit disappointing, right? Couldn't it have been super duper with 2 meters? Auto fuse only for... Is it only for the AC or is it for the mains? I don't know. So how about... Ooh, yeah, you see? It was dropped on the floor. Ah, yeah. There's supposed to be some rubber feet, just some sticky rubber feet, and they're missing. So that means those screws, they're going to scratch your table real bad. It is actually really beautiful inside. I am a little bit impressed. See? Lübke. Vario. That is nice. So it is a 30 volt Vario. So that means it is running off some AC 30 volt from this huge transformer. Wow, that is big. Look at that. But it is also really, really heavy. And that will be heat compound on the rear side, because the rear side is also transistors. Yeah, 3055s. Two of those in parallel. And see, the collectors go straight to the positive, and then we've got some emitter resistors. So that is more or less the circuit, right? And what is this bulb doing? Probably some... What? Current limiting for the drivers or some stuff like that? That is a little bit funny. It also looks like this PCB is supposed to be used with transistors. You can see here's the footprint for a transistor, right? And another one here. So probably they reuse this power supply PCB in many other units where they're just mounted like this, probably on the bottom. Maybe we can rotate it and have a look. So that will be AC voltage, AC current, op amp, or some stuff for that. See, there's a sense resistor down there. So that's probably what this circuit is doing. And see, this AC auto fuse is only connected to the AC output. So that'll be the meter selector. I don't know about that. It looks a little bit bent. But of course, there isn't a lot of material up here, so that is probably why it will bend really, really easy. What is all that stuff doing? All those resistors, that looks a little bit weird. What have we got here? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I know what that is. Look at the relays. The relays, they're connected to secondary taps on the transformer, right? And then we select the different voltage ranges. So what we're doing here is we're comparing voltage over the transistors or the set voltage or something like that. All those different voltage ranges. So yeah, this is a comparator. And that was probably an op amp. So that is more or less the circuit. Let's power this up and see if there's any smoke left in this thing. Okay, let's turn on the AC input. Clickety clack. 12. Okay, 12 watts of usage. Ooh, hear this. Ooh, and then the... How nice is that? Wow, look at that. There is a lot of switching. And they forgot to add hysteresis. The voltage selector, what a beginner fault. Look at that. Click. How stupid is that? Clickety clack. That is really, really stupid. Why are we having that many ranges? This is so... I'm sorry. That was just too much fun. So if we got some... And then the DC current. Is this working? Yeah! It seems to be working, right? So let's play with it. Voltage AC. But what is the problem? This thing... Ooh. Very aggressive here at the end. It's not going to zero here. And see? It's probably just a meter adjustment. But I think I'll go and measure the voltages and currents and stuff. See if it's any accurate or not. Have you ever seen? Oh. I'm gonna blow up those relays before the hour is over. Oops. I just measured the voltage output. Zero! And we got voltage here. That can't be good. So, where's that? Ooh. What do you call that? I think we call that very, very bad soldering. Oh, that's definitely not a connection there, right? That gotta be that, right? So now that is soldered. That looks a little bit better. And now, of course, there is a connection. And now we got voltage output. Yay! But, yeah, I also just resoldered the rectifier. What do you think that is? If I move this a little bit, there's not a connection here.
So somebody threw this real hard in the trash can. I better go and look through all sorts of heavy components and look for stuff. How about this sound? That is not so good, is it? You just can't have big heavy components or the PCB hanging in soldering alone. So I've added a piece of wire all the way here. So now it's not going to break again. So now I'm going through all the different things and I noticed this. What kind of connection do you think we got on this piece of PCB and the output here and the voltage measurements and stuff? This can't be good. Ugh. So now it's working. And this is 2 amps. I just adjusted the zero. Let's try and crank this up. 3, 4, 5, 6 amps. And then 7 amps. And it goes constant current mode, 6.1 amp and 0 volts. And then it restores perfectly fine. That's 1 amp. So, I mean, now it's kind of work. And it's not doing this annoying. So it can go to 24.6 volts. And look at that. So this is the 24.6 and looks a little bit more than 26. Okay, it's not, this is not a reference instrument or whatever. This is just, we're in that ballpark, right? So that is 1 amp. Let's crank it up and see if there's any 5 amp, 6 amp, and then it goes a little bit down, right? So that's 6 amps on and off. That is all. So, I mean, DC voltage output really works now, and both the volt and the amp is working. Let's play a little bit with the current adjustment. So this is probably 3 amps, right? So let's see if that is accurate. Let's crank down the amps down to 2 amps. Turn on the okay, so that is 2 amps instead of 3. It's funny with the sounds here, right? Okay, so this is not super accurate. There's probably some trimmers to handle everything. So now we'll try and play with the AC voltage and see if that's accurate. So this is AC voltage output, and that is super accurate. Look at that. I mean, this is all right. This is, of course, a non-regulated output. So that means there'll be a lot more here. See if I crank this up. 35. So you need to compensate a little bit here when you load this. I mean, that is completely expected. But I want to test AC amps. I'm testing this with a 22 ohm resistor. So, oh yeah, thank you very much, honey. So that means if I crank up the voltage to 22 volts, that will be 1 amp, right? Look at that, that is 1 amp. So I really gotta go. Thank you very much for watching. See ya. Bye.